Computers use databases for huge amounts of data. Keeping this list sorted is really important for optimizing the speed of a search. But how do computers get a randomly shuffled database sorted? The most straightforward method to do this is probably selection sort. In this algorithm, the computer searches for the smallest number and will put that one in front. In computer language, this means that we need to put the first number, the 3, into memory, so we can take the second card, number 7, and compare it with the one in memory. If the evaluated card is larger, nothing will happen. But when the third card, number 2, is compared to the one in memory, we will find a smaller number, thus that one will be placed into memory. This process will be continued to the last number in the sequence. So for number 5, nothing will happen. For card A, it will be placed into memory since it is smaller than card number 2. For card number 6, nothing will happen, and the same for card number 8 and card number 4. This process will result in a memory with the smallest value. When we swap the position of that card with the card in front, a start for our sorted list is created. Now, this process has to be repeated a second time, but this time we don't have to evaluate all the numbers since we already know that the first one is placed right. This second iteration will find a smallest number, of course, number 2. That card will now be swapped with the second spot, since this was the second iteration. When we repeat this algorithm 5 times more, we will find our goal, a sorted list. But how efficient is this algorithm? Well, the average performance of this sorting algorithm is in the order of n squared, meaning that doubling the amount of cards to order will result in a quadruple amount of work. Another method to get this list sorted is called bubble sort. This algorithm will compare the first two cards and will swap them if the card on the left is larger than the card on the right. In our list, this is not the case. Now, the second and third card will be compared, and again, if the one on the left is larger, these two will be swapped. This process will be repeated till we reach the end of the chain. As you may notice, the largest card, number 8, will always end up on the right-hand side. When doing a second iteration of this algorithm, the second largest card will now be moved to the second last spot. Repeating this process will eventually create an ordered sequence. But although this algorithm may feel a bit faster than selection sort, also bubble sort has an average performance in the order of n squared. There has to be a faster way, right? Merge sort is an algorithm that works in the order of n times log n. To explain the procedure of this algorithm, we must not see the deck as one sequence, but as individual sequences that we will merge together, hence the name. The first two sequences, or the first two cards, will be put into a new list, with the smallest one in front. This will be done for every duo of cards, creating in total 4 new sequences. Then the first cards of the two sequences on the left hand side will be compared and again put into a new list. In our example, this means that the 2 will get into the new list first, since that one is smaller than card number 3. The smallest number in the right hand side sequence will now be card number 5, which is larger than card number 3. Therefore, the 3 will now be placed next to the 2. Repeating this process once more will result in an ordered list of 4 cards. This can also be done for the remaining 4 cards on the right hand side, also creating an ordered list of 4 cards. As a final iteration, these two lists can now be merged into one as well. At last, I'd like to show you my favorite method of sorting. In BOGO sort, the numbers in the original sequence will be shuffled and put into a new, random order. This new list will now be checked if it by accident was put into the right order. If not, well, just repeat it. This is by far the worst sorting algorithm that you can think of, because this might take literally forever.